The next speaker is Maurice Roux. Maurice Roux played a major role in France, first in the development of classification, and second in the development of analyse des données in the ecology.
Well, this this talk seems a little far from the previous ones, because it's orientated to cluster analysis. But in fact, I will speak also of correspondence analysis. K-means is a special method which is widely used in the community of data analysis. But there are some details, some practical problems to solve. First, the quality of the results depends heavily on the initialization of the method. And in addition, k-means requires the number of clusters to be chosen beforehand. The classical solutions are for the initialization, one of the most used solution is to repeat many random restarts and to retain the solution which maximizes the classical between sum of square distances, which is the quantity which is optimized by the k-means procedure. Now, the number of clusters, this is a quite difficult issue. In general, people try several values of k and retain the one which leads to the best value of some given criterion. The details which I would like to discuss here are first the initialization, how many random initializations are necessary, and second, the number k of clusters, and especially the problem of the criterion to use. The point of view I'll take here is to use a real data set, which is somewhat a challenge, because in general people take artificial data sets where the number of clusters is known in advance. The other method is to try to solve the selection of k, and in particular which criterion is to be used. Now, some people have tried to work with a set of partition coming from k-means or from any other method of classification. And sometimes it is called a cluster ensemble. Is this able to bring more information on the data set? I will review in this presentation some quality indexes of a partition, and I present then a real life data set and a discussion. In the first part, I will talk about 12 classical formulas for evaluating the fit of a partition to a given distance or dissimilarity. Of course, because I am working with real data set, the number k of clusters is not known, so we are constrained to use some formula of fitting between distance and dissimilarity. I will begin with an artificial data set due to my colleague Nakash and Confey in their book Approche problématique de la classification. The quality indexes, I put them into two clusters. First, those which I call parametric, that is, they work directly on the given distances between the object, and those which are non-parametric, which work on ranks of these distances. I will not give the formulas of these indexes because they are well known and they are easy to find in the literature. I will just show here the examples by Nakash and Confé, 20 points in a two-dimension space, a very easy case. This is the results of k-means with for each number of the columns of this table represent the number of clusters. The first column is with two clusters, and then the three clusters, and so on. And the k-means method was used with 50 random restarts. And the rows of the table represent various indexes of quality. In red color, you see the maximum value of each index, except for the DB index. DB means Davis-Bolden index, which works in the reverse. The low values of DB indicates a good partition, but for all the others, the maximum values indicate the best partition. As you can in black color, but in bold characters, the second best value. So you can see that, for instance, the first row indicates the classical between sum of square criterion, and this criterion always increase with the number of clusters, so it is not interesting for determining the optimal number. The same thing for theta criterion. The Davis-Bolden is always decreasing, but it has some peaks, one for four clusters and the other for nine clusters. Now there is a sort of agreement between the remaining indexes about four clusters, except for the tau coefficient, which votes for a three cluster solution. Here is an example. We see that theta is always increasing, or almost increasing, while the Dunn index have several peaks. This is a Davis-Bolden index. It's a very special case because if you look at the formula, the ratio at the numerator, DW mean the within cluster distance, and DB means the between clusters distances. So this is why this index is indicate a better partition when it is close to zero. But in fact, if you look at the trivial partition where all clusters are restricted to only one point, then the within distance is zero, and whatever the case, so dB of k is zero, and the mean value of dB is zero also. So in fact, this index is not very interesting because it is better with the trivial solution, whatever the number of objects. This is when you look at the example of 20 points with the usual k-means, the solution in four clusters is like that. and with the dB value equal to 0.77 and 66. But if you look at this clustering, that is three clusters with only one point, and all the others in big cluster, then the dB value is better than the previous case. But this is very abnormal. And another case here, again, the dB value is again better than the previous one. So this index is not good for judging the quality of a partition. Now, other indexes, three indexes here, Yule, adjusted Rand, and Folks and Mallows indexes, all show a peak about four clusters, but they have a tendency to increase also with the number of clusters. This is Goodman-Kruskal and Kendall-Stowe. Goodman-Kruskal seems not to be useful because it is also almost increasing all along the interval of variation of the number of clusters. Now, non-parametric indexes are based on general on quadruples of objects. We look at the concordant pairs of pairs, because okay, this is a Kendall-Stowe and GK Goodman-Kruskal index, and the last one to be studied is the chi-square on the previous contingency table, 2x2 table, and here again there is a peak and only one peak for four clusters. So at this point, the five indexes listed here are to be discarded because they cannot discriminate really the good number of the right number of clusters. Now I come to correspondence analysis. Because I have the idea to work on the various results of k-means and to look at what happened with the confusion or co-association table where the CII prime elements are just a number of times or where I and I prime fall into the same cluster. And analyzing this table, this co-association table by cluster analysis, gives this one, this graph for the first two axes. And you can see that my feeling is that there are three clusters. But of course, at the top of the graph, at the right top of the graph, you can see that the cluster is subdivided into two clusters. Now, you can see also here that there is a B point here, which is a little far from its own cluster. And again, here there are H and I, which are far from the rest of the cluster. In fact, this corresponds to the B point is here. You can see that it may be an outlier. And H and I are at the border of the same cluster, but at the other end, and close to this cluster here. So I think that correspondence analysis of this special table could be a good help for determining which points are outliers, or which I call sometimes inliers, or anomalous objects, or things like that. Now let us come to real life example. I begin with a leukemia example. The numbers at the end of the name is the number of objects to be classified. So here with leukemia, there are 38 objects, and it is a data table built with 100 genes, and the inside the table there are the quantitative levels of genes expression. And in this experiment, there are three groups which are known a priori. And if you make correspondence analysis of the raw data table, then the three groups are really visible. But you can see again that there is a B point here and another B point here, which are somewhat intermediate between the groups. Now, if we do the same treatment as previously, we can see that there is an agreement on three clusters, second column here. But you see also that Yule and adjusted RAND give four clusters. And I think that this is not a good thing. Here is the correspondence analysis of the co-association table. And you can see that the B group is has a great spread, while the other groups are close together and with a smaller spread. But the point important is the B here and the other B here, which are the same as those we have seen on the previous correspondence graph. Now, this was done. Was done with three clusters analysis. That is, I repeated the K-means analysis, asking for three clusters and 50 random restarts. But at the final of the analysis, there was only 10 distinct partitions. Now, I repeated the same analysis, but asking with four clusters, and again 50 random restarts. Now we obtain 45 distinct partitions, and the three groups are well visible here. But again, you have a B point here, far from its own group here, and another B point, which corresponds to the same as those which have already seen, which is very close to the group of T. Now, what about the number of restarts? In fact, it seemed that the number of random restarts is not very important. As you can see here, the upper part of the table gives between sum of squares. And you see that for 2, 3, and 4 clusters, whatever the number of restarts, we get the same partition. But of course, when increasing the number of clusters, the experience with 5,000 restarts, of course, give best result, but not always best result. For instance, for 8 clusters, the partition was better with 1,000 restarts, better than the one with 5,000 restarts. Now, if you look at the second part of the table, this is this is concerned with the tau coefficient. And you can see that with the tau coefficient, the 5,000 restarts doesn't give always the best result. Now, let us go to a second example. This is a table which I worked the first time in 1967. It was the first time where correspondence analysis was applied to an ecological example. And the table is made of 55 relevé of places or of observation and 174 species, and only with the presence or absence of species coded 1 or 0. In fact, for using the k-means, I take a new data table made of the 10 principal coordinates axes from starting with the Jacquard's distances. This is the results of the principal coordinates. And you can see that at the upper part of the graph, there are more or less three groups, rather well visible, one here, and the third one here, with this point here a little apart. But in the lower part of the graph, it is very difficult to make groups. Maybe here there is a gap, but this is not evident. And in addition, here we have only 15 and about 10, that is 25% of variance. So there are many other axes which are not represented here. Repeating the experiments with k-means, this is the result with 5,000 random restarts. And you can see that there is no agreement between the various indexes. But there are two numbers, namely three clusters and five clusters, which have, which it seems to be good for some indexes. Again, Yule and adjusted RAND doesn't give good results. For instance, here, the Yule coefficient in red triangle here is always increasing. And false and Mallows is always decreasing. And well, now this is the analysis of the co-association table with 100 random restarts. We got 85 distinct partitions, and from this 85 partition, we build up the co-association matrix. And this is the graph of correspondence analysis of the co-association matrix. Now here, it is about sure that there are five clusters. One here, because that point contains three, six, 7 points. Another one here, another here, a small one here. Fourth group here, and the fifth group here. But you can see that there are intermediate or inliers points here, number 27 here, number 30 and 31 here, and number 48 here, which may be included in this group, but it is a little far from it. In fact, those points, 27 here and 30 and 31, and number 17 here, were well known to be difficult to clusterize. again, this is the comparison between 100 restarts, 1,000 restarts, and 5,000 restarts with the tau coefficient. And you can see that there is no agreement of the number beyond the 5 cluster number. The last example is about yeast, is about genetics of yeast, and this is a levure in French. The data table is made of 237 genes taken at 17 time points, and we have again the quantitative level of gene expression. And there are four groups which were determined a priori as functional categories. Now, if we make the same, the first treatment was a principal components analysis. I'll take PCA because there was some pre-treatment, standardizing pre-treatment, which gave negative values in the data table. So you can see that here it is not at all visible that there are groups in the data. Here in the analysis of the k-means results, you can see also that there are not really agreement between the last six indexes. Apart maybe for the 9 cluster peak, but in fact we know that there are 4 clusters, so there should be 4 clusters. This is a graph of these indexes, and you can see the peak at 9 clusters and the peak at 4 clusters also, but not for adjusted RAND index. And this is the analysis of the co-association matrix with 36 distinct partitions. And you can see a magnificent Gutmann's effect. This is for axis 1 and 2. But if you continue with axis 1 and 3, there is the third degree curve, which means that there is a very strong Gutmann's effect. And if you look at the numbers are correspond to the 5 known groups. And you can see that there is a mixture. There is no pure group with whatever the graph. Now, if we put the results of the k-means, the result for 4 clusters, you can see that in fact there are the 4 groups are easy to see. What does it mean? To my feeling, it's that in fact there is no clusters really. There is rather some continuum situation. That is, you can go from one point to other through small variations. Again, this is for the number of restarts. Finally, the discussion will about the quality indexes. There are many quality indexes that we much discard. These are listed here. Finally, it remains only 3 indexes: the Dunn index, tau index, and chi-square index. But tau and chi-square are based on quadruples, so they are very time-consuming. So finally, I prefer the Dunn index, the formula of which is here. And in fact, it is a modified version of Dunn, which was a little unstable in its original setting. About the number of random restarts, Of course, the number of distinct local optima increases with the number of objects and with the number of clusters. And in general, increasing the number of random restarts does not change for the choice of the number of clusters. So this parameter is not so important. Now, we have seen that correspondence analysis may be a very important help for interpreting the results of the K-means partition. Of course, there are many other initializations possible, but I focus on the usual multiple restarts. And of course, there are limits of the present approach. One is the necessary limited size of the data table, because if you have thousands of objects, you have a co-association matrix which is enormous, and it is very difficult to make a correspondence analysis of it and to extract the good results. Another remark, when there exists a known partition of the data, this is not always an help for determining the real number of clusters. Thank you for your attention.